हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज अतीश एंड आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन द कोर्स अप्लाइड मैथमेटिक्स। अंडर दिस कोर्स यू मे फाइंड मैनी लर्निंग वीडियोस एंड इन दिस लर्निंग वीडियो वी विल लर्न द बेसिक्स ऑफ मैट्रिसेस। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद। सो व्हाट इज मैट्रिक्स? व्हेनेवर वी कम अक्रॉस दिस वर्ड मैट्रिक्स और मैट्रिसेस, व्हाट कम्स टू आवर माइंड फर्स्ट? The thing that comes to our mind first is nothing but an arrangement consisting of some rows and some column. Okay, for example, a classroom. A classroom is a perfect example of matrix. Okay, so let us see the bookish definition of matrix. A set of mn numbers arrange in a rectangular form of m rows and n column is called as matrix of order m by n, and we generally read it as a matrix of order m by n or sometimes as m by n matrix. Okay, now how many matrix one can write? One can write as many matrix as we want. Okay, and it depends on order. Someone want to write a matrix of 2 by 2, someone want to write a matrix of 3 by 2, 2 by 3, it depends. Okay, so let us take an example of 2 by 3 matrix. Whenever we say a matrix of 2 by 3, so how many rows? 2 rows. And how many columns? 3 columns. So 2 rows, and let us write any element: 1, minus 1, 7, 6, 4, 9. So how many rows? 2. And how many columns? 3. So this is a matrix of order 2 by 3. If you want to see the general matrix, this is the general matrix. Okay, how many rows are there? M rows are there, and how many columns? N columns. That is why this is written as M by N. One remark I would like to make about the matrix is matrices or a matrix are generally denoted by capital alphabet. Some write it as, say, A. We have defined one matrix of order 2 by 3. Let us give it a name, say B. Okay. And if you wish to represent the entire matrix by a single notation, so you may write like this: A is equal to Aij m by n, where what is Aij? Aij is nothing but an element, sometimes also called as the entry. Aij is an element of ith row and jth column, where I varying from 1 to m and j varying from 1 to n. Okay. The next thing is, you may be dealing with programming languages, maybe in this year or maybe in future. So in programming languages, matrix is known as array. Okay, now the next thing is the notation of for matrices. One notation that we have seen, okay, that is this, the notations. So what are the notations? One notation is this. This is the notation. Another notation, you can write matrices inside this. Now these two notations that I have written here are very well known to you. And whenever we are learning anything, there must be a value addition. Okay. So let me tell you a very rare known notation for matrix. The elements of the matrix can be written inside this notation also. Suppose you have a 2 by 2 matrix, so one can write 4, 5, 9, 11. Okay, so here it is, a value addition for learning. Okay, so these are the notations. Now, after this matrix, there are so many things that one should know. Okay, so the things which we should know are the type of matrices. So matrix that we are going to learn is a null matrix, or sometimes also called as zero matrix. Okay, so this is null or zero matrix. So what is null matrix? Any matrix whose all the elements are zero is called as null matrix or zero matrix. A matrix A having all the elements zero is called as null matrix or zero matrix. Suppose you have this matrix, null matrix, so you can put element like 0, 0. No other options available. All the elements should be 0. And these null matrix are denoted by O. Sometimes, not always. Okay, so let's move on to the next matrix, which is row matrix. So what is row matrix? A matrix which has only single row and any number of columns is called as row matrix. For example, row matrix. So how many row in a row matrix? There always be a single row and there is no restriction on the number of columns. So one row, and now you put any number of columns: 1, 7, 13, 29. So this is a row matrix. Now eventually, once you have a definition of row matrix, can you predict what definition would be the next? Yes, good, column matrix. So this is the next definition. Now you can pause the video for a few seconds and try to construct the definition of column matrix. What is column matrix? Take your time and try to write down the definition of column matrix. I hope you have written the definition of column matrix. So what is column matrix? A matrix having single column but any number of rows. You might have written example also. So single column and any number of rows. Is it? And what is the order of this matrix? 1 by 4. What is the order of this matrix? 3 by 1. Is it? Now the next definition is of square matrix. So can you define square matrix? Yes? Okay. So what is square matrix? A square matrix is a matrix whose number of rows and number of columns are same. Okay, so this is the definition. A matrix having same number of rows and columns is called as square matrix. Okay, very simple definition. Now, the next definition is of identity matrix, or called as unit matrix. So what is identity matrix? It is nothing but a scalar matrix whose every diagonal element is 1. Okay, so that is the condition for the identity or unit matrix. First of all, it should be a scalar matrix. So non-diagonal elements are 0 and diagonal elements are same, but we are still restricted to the diagonal element should be 1. Okay, so what we can say? A scalar matrix whose every diagonal element is 1 is called an identity matrix. So what is identity matrix? Identity matrix is a son of scalar matrix and a grandson of diagonal matrix. Okay, so it is like this: diagonal element, and then its son is scalar matrix, and its scalar matrix and its son is unit or identity matrix. Okay, so these are the definition we have in the basics. And yes, we were talking about the unit matrix. So a unit matrix of order 2 is this. Can you write unit matrix of order 3? Yes, I will write I3 or I just all the diagonal element as 1 and non-diagonal element as 0. Now, my question is, can you write an example of identity matrix of order 1? So order 1 means one element, one row, one column. So what it should be? It should be 0 or 1? It should be 1 because its diagonal element is this, and we have to put 1 as a diagonal element, and it don't have any non-diagonal element. Okay, so this is an example of identity or unit matrix. Okay, so these are the definition. For the time being, we can continue with the more definitions, and I think the definition which are relevant to the course. Okay, relevant to the topics that we have in the course, we will cover only those definition, because if you start with the matrices, it will take 2-3 prerequisite classes to just know the types of matrices. Okay, if we are talking about the beyond syllabus, there are so many matrices like involutory, nilpotent matrix, idempotent matrix, then singular, non-singular. Because these definition needs to be learned if we know the determinant. For singular and non-singular matrix, we need to learn the determinant. Okay, one simple definition I will take after this. The next definition is of transpose of a matrix. So what is transpose of a matrix? Suppose we are given a matrix A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, this is a matrix. So to write down the transpose of a matrix, what we need to do? The transpose of a matrix is obtained by interchanging the rows and column. So this row will become a column, and this row will become a column like this. Okay, so what we can say, this matrix is nothing but the transpose of the matrix A, and the transpose of a matrix is generally denoted by A dash, or sometimes it is denoted by A transpose. Okay, so these are the matrices or the definition of matrices we have, and still 2-3 definition we can still talk about, like symmetric matrix and non-symmetric matrix. Symmetric matrix. So what is a symmetric matrix? Suppose we have a matrix A, and if you take its transpose, what is its transpose? AT. And if A is same as A transpose, then we say that the matrix A is a symmetric matrix. Okay, if this is symmetric matrix, likewise you can define non-symmetric matrix. Okay, so a matrix A is said to be a non-symmetric matrix if the matrix is same as negation of its transpose. Okay, so these are the matrix we need for the course. So we have include all the definition that we need, and as and when required, we'll make use of the definitions that we have taken in this learning video. And if we need some more definition, we will again borrow those definitions. Okay, so for the prerequisite one class, it is enough for the day, I guess. Okay, so thank you for watching this learning video, and happy learning.